In late August of 2017, Tropical Storm Harvey stalled along the Texas Gulf Coast, dropping a staggering 35 to 60 inches of rain. Harvey produced more rainfall than any other tropical cyclone on record in the U.S., and it flooded an area the size of New Jersey. On Saturday, August 26th, Harvey's forward speed had slowed to a crawl, and overnight into Sunday, bands of heavy rain produced as much as 25 inches of rain in Houston, about half of the city's annual average. Most of that 25 inches fell in under 12 hours. That weekend, 10 flash flood emergencies were issued by the National Weather Service in Houston. High water rescues exploded across the city. It was so bad that a Harris County official sent out an urgent plea asking for help from boat owners. Floodwaters swallowed up major roads, including large sections of Interstates 10 and 45. Thousands of people were rescued. 300,000 structures were inundated, along with 500,000 cars. It's unlikely that any other U.S. tropical cyclone caused flooding that was as widespread. The damage was estimated at $125 billion. On top of all that, there were dozens of cases of toxic chemicals being released into the floodwaters, primarily along the Houston Ship Channel. Benzene, vinyl chloride, and other carcinogens were released, along with hundreds of thousands of gallons of industrial wastewater, making an unprecedented storm even worse. Part of what made Harvey so devastating was a weak front draped across the coast as the storm moved in. This focused and intensified the rainfall. But there's also evidence that tropical cyclone rainfall rates are increasing, and two studies concluded that Harvey's extreme rainfall was indeed enhanced by warming. Tropical Storm Harvey's very slow forward movement also played a major role in the disaster, and researchers have detected a slowing in the forward speed of tropical cyclones, though this change has not yet been confidently linked to warming. Future storms are projected to produce heavier rainfall and to move more slowly. For highly populous and hurricane-vulnerable cities such as Houston, climate resilience planning is critical.